19th, 2017. As far as agenda items, I know we did an awful lot in our last meeting as far as sort of housekeeping, but we do have some other meetings, minutes of meetings to approve. We do have the health reports from Laura. There were just a couple of questions. Did she go over any of, like, the complaints at all? It said it was a report with a complaint. Was there reports with that?
I didn't see any reports, no. I think they're probably in the file.
Okay. Well, it just said on the note that she sent us, it just said see report.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't notice that in the packet.
Yeah, no, it wasn't in the packet.
Okay. Let's see. Pesticide regulations go on again tonight. If you guys maybe have had a chance to look at them and get familiar with them.
Yeah, I printed it if anybody wants to. And it says you're free to copy and distribute.
I did read that, yeah.
But I mean, it's like 70 pages or something.
And there was also something this week from Nancy. I don't know if something about a DPH follow-up. Did you meet with Bob or anything with that?
I did, yeah.
Okay, good.
Yep, he's following up on that, so I think we're all set.
Okay, good. Has everyone had a chance to read the minutes of the past couple meetings?
Yes.
Let's see, the ones of the August the 16th, you weren't here on the 16th.
Hi, Nancy.
Good. Nancy, we're just going over minutes out of August the 16th, which I believe just you and I were here. I did get a communication from Laura to maybe amend the paragraph of the minutes of the, I think that was the 16th. Get yourself together, Nancy.
Sorry.
No problem. Did you get a chance to see Laura's email? I guess it was sent from Laura to, I think, the whole board. Just in the body of the minutes.
Okay.
From what I gathered, maybe in the chair report,
mm-hmm.
in maybe the first, second,
chair
third,
report
fourth.
Right here. Okay.
Yeah, on the second page, I think maybe the fourth paragraph.
Okay.
It says she was asked what happened that she wasn't able to return. She applied. She was not able to do an inspection. She would like to edit it to, in the body of the paragraph, please add, Vlasic was asked what happened that she wasn't able to return. Vlasic replied, I appointed by the board, so I cannot do an inspection. I guess I'm not appointed by the board, so I cannot do an inspection.
I thought that's what she wrote. She replied she was not able to do an inspection because she had not been appointed by the board. So am I missing something here?
That is where it says.
So what is she changing that to?
I'm not sure. I just got an email saying.
Okay.
Yeah. I wonder, was that this meeting or the one? I don't know. It wasn't identified.
Oh, sorry.
This is
okay.
What she wants to replace it with.
So
this paragraph.
Okay.
Do you have
Kevin
in the body?
I have the email. Did you change it in the when you sent out? Okay.
She was able to return. Period. She replied.
So is this the change or is this the original?
That's the original.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Sorry, I did have that. I was just looking at that on my computer.
So it's the paragraph that starts. Doctor went to the location. That paragraph.
It
no.
starts. No.
Vlasic
was asked.
One. Okay.
And basically, it says what she says.
I thought it says the same thing. I mean, seems redundant, so I don't quite know.
Yeah, that's, I didn't really look too much into the minutes, just.
Well, there's more, it looks like there's more verbiage added in here.
Right, I think it's.
So rather than, goes on in here to say she stated it was not overflowing, but up here it goes on to say, so I cannot do an inspection, so I'm assuming she wanted to stick that in between those, that sentence, because that's the difference between what she said in the draft here.
She was, not because she had not.
That's not further down, right? No, so, she replies not able to do an inspection, has not been appointed by the board, period, and then on here, it says the same thing, but then it goes on to say, next line is, she stated it was not overflowing toilet. On her correction, goes on to say, so I could not do an inspection, so it was not that I told him I was not doing his inspection, I told him that I was not able to do his inspection since I have not been appointed by the board. So I'm assuming she wants to insert that line in between.
Unless there's also another.
The second sentence.
Maybe she wants to change this one.
Could we wait till she's here? I mean, we don't have to approve this.
Yeah.
I mean, it would, rather than us trying to assume what Laura wants.
Oh, I see what you're saying, Heidi, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's the second, that small little paragraph.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Why don't we just wait until she's here?
No pressing need for that.
Okay.
So can we, with Darlene, edit with what we think it is, because.
No, we're not gonna.
Well, we're just not gonna approve it tonight until we, I mean, it looked a little redundant, so I'm not quite sure exactly what she wanted it to say or change it to from.
I think we should hold off.
Yeah, what I interpreted to be is a simple insert of the sentence, so I cannot do an inspection. That's what I understood it to be.
That's what it seemed like, yeah.
I think we should wait till Laura's here, rather than trying to go through a third party. Might as well speak to her directly.
Okay, I mean, it basically does say what she said here, and I was just trying to clarify what.
No, I'm fine holding off. Heidi, you wanna wait until we can actually know what she wants?
Yeah, there's another paragraph, I think that's what she meant, a smaller paragraph.
That's what the problem is.
The next one, Sherland asked, but I think that's where she, because it made it sound like she hadn't done any inspections, but she, I think she meant to.
Yeah, I don't wanna guess for someone who's not here.
Oh, I see what you're saying, Heidi, that is the fifth paragraph technically, right?
She says, paragraph 5 in the body of the chair report.
Okay.
So chair report.
Three, four, it's that small little one, 5 is a small one.
Well, the chair report starts with the town manager contacted Costigan, that to me is paragraph 1.
Right, where it stops with update, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
And it starts, the second one starts at Costigan contact, that's a second, paragraph, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so 3, 4, 5.
I think Lorenta Vlasic was asked that paragraph.
So Heidi, I think what you're doing is you're counting the fifth on this page, and we're counting the,
I thought the first.
Yeah, it almost reads like a continuation from the front, Heidi, yeah.
And that's why I don't think we should vote on these until we know what she would like.
Yeah, that is the fifth paragraph, though. Vlasic was asked what happened.
It's easy enough. We can just do it at the next meeting.
Okay.
That's fine. And then the for the minutes of the 16th.
For the 16th. Because that was the 16th.
That was the 16th, I'm sorry, September 6th, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Would we be posting these minutes, these draft minutes, so that at least the minutes get posted?
They are public record already.
I think that's important to get the minutes up on the website as a draft.
We typically don't?
I don't know that we've ever run into this with this board, but getting the minutes up and posted is something we're really concerned about, so that we have our, public records all online.
The approved minutes, you're referring to, right?
I don't think we can put a draft if they haven't been approved.
Yeah. Well, technically, as soon as Darlene puts pen to paper, they're official.
Yeah, the drafts
and they can be requested.
It's a matter of public record.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna put, you wanna put the draft minutes up?
I'm throwing that out there to the board.
Just You have the draft watermark on them, I guess you could put that into the PDF.
You can put a draft, or you could say, see RCTV. I mean, that is out there, I mean.
Don't we have a guideline of 30 days for approval, generally, townwide?
I think so, yeah.
So, please take that into account.
Yeah, I mean, these minutes go back to August, it's almost October.
I know, but I was out for 2 weeks.
Yes.
Before I was out to do them.
No, I understand, I'm not saying anything about, I'm just saying, for the public to be able to look at minutes.
Purely from the public.
Yeah.
We're still meeting state by once.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like we're not comfortable in approving it without actually making sure what we're approving, but we can get it out.
We can put a draft out.
We can still put a draft on it, correct?
Yeah.
And just it would be approved at our next meeting when we.
Yeah, just so long as it's got that, like you said, Darlene, just like that nice big draft written across it.
There you go.
Mr. Chairman, while we're discussing the August minutes, I believe evenings and executive sessions were held were the 8th and the 15th, is that correct? To our regular election.
It was the night before our meeting, which would have been the 15th and the 8th.
I'm pretty sure they were. There should be two sets of minutes for each of those meetings, one for the public part of the meeting and one for the executive session. Is the public part available?
They may be.
There was a vote taken in the, on the 8th, I know, in the public session for an information request. I've not seen that in any set of minutes that's been discussed or released. Did you do minutes for those, Darlene? For the public session, of course.
Let's say the minutes of the 8th were tabled until the next meeting.
We went over those before the selectmen's meetings, right?
You know what I'm saying? That there should be two sets of minutes for any meeting that contains an executive session.
I think I may have given one that's an open to the town clerk, that may be my mistake, that I gave that to Lord Jimmy. For one of them, the open portion that we met at, when we met in the conference room. I believe I gave that open session also to Lord Jimmy along with the executive session.
So you approved both an executive?
Darlene was not at that meeting, so I believe I gave the open meeting.
So you had a composite set of minutes for that whole meeting?
For the, I'm getting confused on dates.
The 8th and the 15th, the ones that I was not there.
Oh, okay.
We did talk, we did.
Approve those.
The 16th, we did approve those.
We approved all of those, yes.
Well, I, yes.
You approved two sets for each evening?
Yes.
Well, I abstained because I wasn't there.
Right, but they were approved, so where are the minutes for the 8th and the 15th for open session? Have they been released?
So, I have the draft, wasn't at the other meeting, so I didn't know they were approved, so I can.
All I'm asking is if they've been approved, that they've been put up on the website.
Well, the executive.
No, the open part.
The regular.
Until you agree on releasing the executive, that's.
Darlene hasn't been back to our meetings to do this, she's been away.
Okay. I'm just asking if that would be done, please.
Now, did you submit the executive session, Solara?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's, she has them all.
Okay.
And so when do we have to, when does the board need to approve those?
That's up to the board.
Well, the executive session meeting has been approved.
They've been approved, it's about release.
Okay, oh, you've already approved them?
They've approved them.
Okay.
Yes.
So the release just comes dependent on if they can be released?
That's up to the board.
Correct. Now, the open meeting part of it have been approved also, correct?
No, because we, the open meeting part for the one that we did when Darlene was not here, I also included that to the town clerk.
Oh, that's, okay, that's all part of that, okay.
And that's my bad, and I can bring that back in here.
Okay.
I'm happy to do that. I believe I gave that all to Laura.
Okay.
That was mine. I will get that back.
Does that answer your question, Dan?
Yes, thank you.
And for the minutes of our last meeting on September 6th, has everyone had a chance to look those over?
Yes.
I just noticed one thing on the top of page, well, I guess it would be in the Cafe Pavarotti on the top of this page, I guess it would be the third page of the minutes, which would be the top paragraph. started with Mr. Costigan, stated Mr. Jackson informed him.
Okay, yeah.
That should be inspected every, twice a year rather than every 2 years.
Twice a year, yeah, that's right.
Sorry, I missed that.
No, no problem.
So it's gonna be?
Page three, Donna.
Page three.
Very, right at the top, the very first sentence.
Top of the third page of the minutes of the sixth, 9/6. The end of the first sentence, inspected every 2 years, that should be inspected twice a year. And is up to fire code. I may have, that may have been my problem between biannual and semi-annual. I may have gotten them confused. But it is twice a year. Any other comments on the minutes?
Did your name spell correctly, Heidi?
In some places it is, in some places it is, but it's all right.
Well, that's your new nickname.
It's just the letter, it's just sometimes I E, but it's E I, so.
E I F E R.
That's right.
Is there some rule after C or something?
Yeah, that's correct, yeah, but just some of the thing, but that's okay.
We'll wanna make sure we get it right, yeah.
Like some other.
Oh, it's E I, okay.
Yeah, I think it's in the bottom, and that's it, like then on page three, it's, I can circle on it.
Oh, I have one.
There's a lot.
Yeah, you gotta, I can see that, no, okay.
I did not draft, I did this, it's all random. It says, Miss Doctor will forward the draft, that's the signs of that was you.
Okay, yes.
So that's supposed to be John. So Darlene, just one other change, on the top of page five, the second sentence, you should change my name to John. You was gonna actually send Laura the pesticide regs?
And I did send those to Laura, and I'm assuming that the rest of the board got them okay, that.
Yes.
The regulations, okay. Is there a motion to accept the minutes from September 6th?
A motion to accept the minutes from September 6th as amended.
A motion on the floor to accept the minutes.
Second
motion seconded. All those in favor of approving minutes of September 8th, 6th? Favor, aye. 3-0 down to approve the minutes of September the 6th. Next on the agenda is the health reports from August. I apologize, Laura's not here. In our change of the meeting, I neglected to make sure that Laura would be here on tonight. So I apologize for Laura not being here. The only thing I looked on as far as this were the complaints that were just a little alarming. I wasn't aware of any complaints that we had received, and I did see that there were reports on it. Now, where are those reports, Jean? Would we know the reports for that?
I'll defer to Darlene. I'm not exactly sure where those are kept.
I haven't seen those.
So we don't know where
it should be. Some sort of a form, I believe, that gets filled out, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it said see reports on the sheet, and I didn't know where to look.
Now, the report's something that's typically put in the packets?
A summary is.
A summary, but not the report itself.
Summary, and
summary.
That's what we're going to discuss.
And then we go through and we can discuss in detail.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, if there were some action to be taken, you know, that's what the report might indicate. Mm-hmm.
I know there was a email that went through. Bob Gracie was working on the Reading Learning Center. The other two I'm not familiar with, I'm sorry.
Right, so we can't really address them because we don't know what they are. See reports.
Would it be something where Laura could follow up with the chair and get some more information on this?
Yeah, sure. I'm just assuming that it's not something urgent enough that we would have to make any actions on. But yeah, as soon as possible, sure.
Okay. I'll ask Laura to get in touch with you and give you the additional information.
And actually, probably to the whole board. I mean, that's because I can't communicate to the rest of the board what she sends me, so she could pretty much send it to the board.
To everyone, yeah. And that way, then, if we have questions, we can direct it right to Laura.
Back to her, and then...
I think we have to be careful on that one. The board really can't deliberate electronically.
We're not talking about deliberate. We can communicate with Laura directly as individuals.
Individually, okay.
Yeah.
That's what we're saying.
Yeah, okay, gotcha.
And if it came to the, I mean, if it was something...
If it comes to John, then we can't talk.
Right. Or I suppose if she could send it to me, then I could determine whether it was... But, you know, just as far as transparency, if everyone was kept up to date on anything.
Okay.
Particularly if someone had a specific question.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions about the health report? Gina, are you aware, are we going to be working with Walmart for our flu shots?
Yes, that is the plan. Yep.
And is that going to be run along with the senior, our senior center? Through that, or is that through the health department? The health division?
We're basically collaborating with the town of North Reading, and we're doing something very similar to what they're doing. And the flyer, there's a draft of a flyer, but it's not quite finished. But I have the dates. So Saturday, October 14th from 11 to 1 p.m. at Walmart. And Monday, October 24th, from 4 to 7.
Tuesday.
That's
Tuesday.
Tuesday, October 25th.
Okay.
No, I think it's the 4th.
It's the 4th.
It's the Tuesday. 24th.
Tuesday.
Yeah. 24th.
That's 4 to 7.
The 24th. 4 to 7 at Coolidge Middle School. And then there are some other additional clinics, depending on response. They're going to see about additional clinics.
Now, the one at Coolidge, is that going to be with our own health nurse administering the shots?
Well, this is all with the help of Walmart.
Okay.
So, we can still use the MRC.
So for the 20... I'm confused. I was under the understanding that October 24th that Sue would be there.
Oh, that's very possible, but this is all under the...
This one didn't have anything to do with Walmart.
I think we are getting some assistance. I don't know the level of assistance from Walmart. But in collaboration with Walmart, we're offering these clinics. The Coolidge Middle School, I think you're right, it's a little bit different than the Walmart Saturday 1 o'clock.
And Sue has also volunteered with MRC, so it would be a matter of giving Dave Nichols a heads up. He needs a couple of weeks heads up lead time to put out the mass email to get volunteers to sign up.
Okay. Would Sue handle that, or would...
It would probably have to come from you because you're the chair to ask. So if you want to, I'll send you Dave Nichols' information once we clarify with Sue whether or not she's bringing in her own volunteers or not. If not, we can get Reading nurses that volunteer.
So Sue is coordinating that.
That's what we don't know.
And believe she is coordinating October 24th. And that she was gonna be there, and I thought maybe utilize MRC.
So maybe what you wanna do is send Sue an email and ask her whether or not she needs MRC volunteers. And then I can send you Dave Nichols' information, and he just sends out, you know, what you need.
Okay, no, I just why I hadn't been familiar with what had gone on.
You can have to make sure I give you that information.
Okay, any other health report questions? Or issues? Let's see, next are on the agenda, the pesticide regulations. Our new members are up and running. Any questions or anything that you may not have understood?
Yeah, and I also, hopefully those links helped you in terms of what I sent you.
I did get the link, yes, thank you very much.
I sent them the link that we had used. It's a mass municipality that we had used early on to write these.
Okay. I guess the reason I ask is the next step that I would like to take, along with meeting with our selectmen, is holding a public hearing to get the input from the rest of the citizens in town.
So is that something we do first before we go to the selectmen?
We could probably do it. I think that would be part of the whole process. I don't think we have to, although I would like to get maybe even present the selectmen with some of the issues that the town has as just to foster the idea that it is wanted in town. I mean, Dan, do you get a feeling that there's any opposition to that?
I don't think it's an issue. It's not top of mind aware for most people. Mm-hmm. I don't think they form an opinion one way or the other. If they thought about it, they might have an opinion. But ordinarily, you wouldn't have a hearing over something that you sort of acknowledge is not in your wheelhouse, but mm-hmm. I don't see the harm of it on the other hand, as a just an educational vehicle.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep.
I wouldn't have any problem with it.
And have the selectmen...
Nancy just forwarded that we've not had a chance, but I will speak to Chairman Arena and try to schedule that for a future evening.
Okay.
Won't be the next meeting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Might be the one after, maybe later on. Okay. October, possibly November.
So could we go back and do what we had proposed and just during our next Board of Health meeting have it be a public open and do it at the same time, which is what we had planned to do in August? Do the same thing?
Yeah, I think that would be fine. I mean, any information of support we could give the selectmen, I would think, to of the town would be helpful to the selectmen.
But I make a suggestion that you have it more toward normal meeting hours in the evening so people that work during the day could attend it.
Mm-hmm.
7 p.m.
And like, and a big, yeah, a bigger venue.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So at the senior center?
Do that.
Or the station?
Or the library.
Or the library.
Maybe the library.
Yeah, any of those would be fine. I don't know if our room is available. Probably not.
I think, yeah, okay.
It's Commerce. Somebody's in there.
Good.
So if we do it for our next meeting, then, Darlene, would you be able to secure something?
A location?
A location for a bigger venue?
What's the next meeting?
Let's see, what's the third? Let's try for the third Wednesday.
The third Wednesday would be the 18th.
Yeah, the zoning board meets that night too. I don't know. I don't know where they're meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Are you saying there could be a staff constraint there for?
No, I was just thinking in terms of what rooms are already booked.
I think we have lots of rooms. Libraries available, police station's a good choice.
And sometimes the zoning board meets at the senior center, so that.
Oh.
Right.
That could be the only issue.
Should we shoot for the 18th and see what we can find?
Okay. And what's the, what do you think's a good format besides us having the regulations available?
Well, question and answer maybe.
Okay.
And, well, I mean, basically a public hearing would be hearing from the public.
Right.
And, I mean, would we really want to say much of anything?
Have our regulations available?
Yes.
Mary Ellen O'Neill. Well, I think first if someone would present a brief summary of regulations and what their intent is. People are interested, they may not read them. I was curious to know how many pages they are. I don't think they're that long.
Wasn't that long?
It's not that long.
Yeah, it's not that long.
Tailored down some things that didn't apply to Reading, you know, things that DPW didn't feel we needed to do the testing in the compost center. You know, some of the things we dropped the advisory board.
And maybe something about what our DPW, how they already handle, what their applications or consist of on school grounds and parks and things like that.
It's already under the state, yeah.
Yeah, but so something that just kind of, just assume that people are interested but haven't read them, and then make a brief presentation of some of the background and what these would do, what the town does now, and then what these would do. It doesn't have to be long, like 5 minutes less.
Yeah, because I mean, we can't, we won't be changing anything that the town does, basically.
No, but I think maybe people don't know some of the background, like some of the background in the state law, the Mass Law on Protection of Family
Children,
that you can't do certain things on school grounds, and how the town does that. What we already do, that's very positive. It's just more information. Because to me, this is the main point of this whole thing, is really information, education is the foundation for that. Not really, from my point of view, meant to be punitive, but it's more to, you know, educate. Maybe get some results for us, educate people.
So this would be portrayed as getting information to recommend to the selectmen for guidelines we would put in place for tree lawns and that kind of thing. That,
yes.
That's going to be your framework. Presenting the information.
Now,
since town council's ruled that you don't per se have jurisdiction,
we do not have jurisdiction.
Right.
Would you want to take over the regulatory?
Right, and we're attentive and listening to the comments.
Okay.
Right.
Yes. So the 18th, does that sound like a reasonable date to shoot for? Darlene, maybe we could see what might be available for the 18th of October.
No, that's not the financial forum. We're okay. I think. Yeah, that's the 14th. Oh, is that the night that Yes for Reading is meeting? I don't know if that would intersect with any of the people that would be coming, but whatever.
They got their meetings on Facebook then? Let's see.
I think so. They're meeting at the Universal Unitarian.
I know, but there's always going to be a meeting.
There will always be a meeting.
There will always be one.
Yeah.
That one you think would take a lot of.
Yeah, I think you might.
Would take a lot of people in though with it.
Mm-hmm.
No, the 11th. They have, well. Well, they haven't posted anything that they're meeting on, just some other meetings around town.
Well, that one's not up.
Not on their site anyway.
Yeah, we got an informal heads up on that, so I can save the date.
Kind of, oh, okay. They haven't put it up yet.
I think it was the 18th. I didn't bring the second over.
What I'll do is I'll dig up the stuff about the state regs that they already follow and just send those to you because they're very clear what.
Okay.
Mary Ellen was saying about
sure.
Pa- parks, schools, daycare, all of that. We're not duplicating any of that, those are already the state regs. So I'll get you all of the Mass General Law stuff.
So we don't do things like town hall right now? We don't have that in place for town hall, another city, another town-owned buildings, just the schools?
Well, what I'm saying, there's Mass General Law that actually has very clear guidelines about anything near wetlands, streams, schools, parks, all of that.
But this is all, what I'm saying, this encompasses, we're not doing it right now at town hall. This would encompass town hall and other, town buildings, or just the tree lawns?
Just the tree lawns.
And sidewalks.
Okay.
I'm hoping sidewalks, right?
Well, yeah, that's part of it, yeah. We're only talking about...
The public property portion, which is usually in board, includes the sidewalk.
The town doesn't actually use pesticides pretty much anywhere.
Okay.
They don't use DPW. When they do, it's for very specific infestations. I think the one that we talked about is a moth, a gypsy, don't quote me, it was gypsy moth or whichever it was that we spoke about. But it's very specific. They don't use pesticides.
Okay.
There's also been a change in some of the product composition. They have a product called 8. It's much less toxic than 7 was. Figures 8. It's more organic, I think, and it works pretty well.
Right, people forget what Agent Orange is. Agent Orange is a herbicide, so.
Yeah.
Are the revised draft regulations proposed online that I or other people could read? Have they posted?
I don't think we've posted them up yet, just because we've been back and forth editing them.
So how will we access them before the hearing, or?
Well, I would have something approved, ready to go for this hearing.
Yeah, I was gonna say, probably better off to put it right in line on the, with the meeting, right on town hall, so people can see exactly what we're talking about. So when you, you know, click on the date.
And those are the ones that we got back from town council.
Town council, yes.
So you have the ones that...
Which is the ones that we just sent around.
One I sent around, and, but that did have still a clause in it about town land, which that was...
Is gonna be directed to, right?
All of the other issues that Ray brought up were addressed, and I guess he was fine with them, that we changed. So yeah, I believe we could put that up as the proposed regulations then.
Yeah, that we're having the open meeting for.
Open meeting and a hearing.
Or public comment or whatever it is called, hearing, yes.
Yeah, definitely want to attach it right to the meeting so people understand that can come out.
For these regulations, this is what we're discussing in the public hearing.
Good point. It'd be nice to note ahead of time.
Yes, I haven't had a chance to read the revised ones.
Okay.
I don't think I got that.
You weren't on that one? Let's see, maybe you weren't.
Those are the new regulations.
Yeah, that was maybe the spelling of your name, but that could have been that.
And the link that I got from you didn't work, but I found something online.
Yes. This, did you get that?
Yeah.
Yes, that's the one I sent you.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Same one.
So I got mine on the 11th. If you want to check your email just to see if it was in there. Maybe check the spam too, because it comes from a, I think it was on that Laura, it looks like Laura sent out, that encompassed a lot of people, but it doesn't have anybody on there.
Did she blind, did she, CC or?
Well, it just looked like it was just coming from her CI.reading account.
Heidi, could you just verify?
But it also said to that, it didn't say it was to me, it went to that, so I wasn't sure if she, you know how a lot of times you can send out from those accounts, multiple accounts, but it only looks like it's coming from you only and going to you only.
Yep.
Yeah, but it goes out to everybody. It looked like it was one of those. So see if you have something on the 11th, either regular or in spam.
Yeah,
otherwise I can forward it.
Yeah, double check with Laura that she has your correct email. That would be a good thing. So, Darlene, you can get back to me or with a meeting, potential meeting place.
Mm-hmm. And just, Heidi or Kevin, do either of you have any questions, though, in terms of the
No, I think my questions mostly got answered through the link that you sent. Thank you, Nancy. I definitely had a lot of questions before them, but they definitely, they pretty much laid out for the most part in there. And I think the biggest part was, you know, through ingestion, inhalation, and skin contact. I guess the only question I have in regard to skin contact, is skin contact absorption, or is that through skin-to-mouth contact?
It's actually both.
Is it both?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was one of the only questions I had in regards to that one, but,
I think it's particularly with children, because
they're
on grass, and they often then just ingest. It's a big issue.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't print out, I just printed out this one. I don't know if you want to look at it in terms of some of the information.
Depending on the composition of the actual pesticide, some get absorbed through the skin easier than others, so it's but very, very possibly through the skin.
Okay.
And the other thing, you know, is that some of these other communities do these really nice handouts that can be attached to our public work newsletters.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's many, many more. Stephen had worked, I think, on a brochure at one point that was going to be folded up. This is just one that I pulled off the internet. This is from Illinois, Indiana. Talks about why it's important. They're just brief little blurbs, but it's something that we could we don't even have to do a big handout. It could just be the same type of thing that
they have. Any extra weight left in the mail, I'm sure.
Yeah, so I mean, they could do something a little bit different in terms of just putting something there. And it just talks about, just again, another way of educating. These were some of the handouts. There's just a ton of stuff that's available that we can utilize for that type of information.
Now, what happens in the meeting if, like, some of these chemicals that they no longer sell, if people have them at their house and they ask us, like, is there some place they can...
Take them to Wakefield on Saturday.
And this coming Saturday, actually. Not next Saturday. This coming Saturday, take them to Wakefield.
Does our town have anything like that?
Do we alternate with Wakefield every year, or do they?
So twice a year, the hazardous waste.
Because it's right here.
Then in the spring, it'll be in Reading.
Okay, so we do alternate back and forth.
Reading had theirs right back in June, I want to say.
May or June. That includes pesticides.
It's anything that's dangerous.
Is it worthwhile to have somebody there that is? From a, that's what I'm looking for here, the other side of it, the organic compounds. Somebody there to weigh in to answer questions, because I'm sure people are going to ask questions. Well, if I don't do this, what can I do?
But that's not the hearing. That would be different.
You want to do an informational gathering first, is that what you're saying?
No, we were going to do a hearing.
Well, yeah, this would be a hearing, although. I mean, I'm not an expert on the organic toxicity of these products.
I can just envision somebody having questions in regards to it.
Mm-hmm. But if you did that, you'd probably want the opposite also. Maybe, a true green.
But I thought a hearing was for us to hear from the community.
To
what
hear.
Their concerns are about.
That's true, and their concerns, they may have questions too, which I,
we can then have a different form, but I'm not sure.
Yep, we could do that too.
Right.
Well, I don't want to bring them up twice.
But,
you might as well do it all in one shot.
If they have questions, it wouldn't be a bad idea to have them answered at that venue.
See, but then I have a concern, you're going to have a landscaper saying, why didn't you invite me?
Well, that's what I was just saying, is you may want both ends of the spectrum. You know, you may want a true green representative to give their side of the story.
But that's what I'm saying. Then you're going to have somebody saying, why did you contact True Green and not, such and such lawn service? They're showing preference to a private company. If we're going to have someone, it would have to be someone who's completely new.
Yeah, I don't know that you'd have a company, but you'd have somebody who's, it's a good point. You'd want to have somebody that is knowledgeable in the industry, right, rather than a company.
A neutral
position that says, I don't work for this or that, but this is what this and that is.
Right, and I don't know anyone at the university level to ask in that regard.
Well, the state level?
DPH.
Yeah, do they think they could lend somebody?
We can find out. This came from the Office of Environmental Affairs, Toxic Use Reduction Institute at the University of Lowell, Massachusetts. I could ask. I don't know. I'll see if I can find mm-hmm. someone.
Okay.
Does anybody know a practitioner in the pest control community that might be willing to speak? I mean, I realize these guys are in the business of killing pests, but on the other hand, there's been a big change in how they do a lot of their work. Mm-hmm. One guy was explaining how they kill ants now. They don't spray with seven anymore. They have this, it's almost like dust. It's very sharp. That slices through the exoskeleton of the ant, which is pretty clever.
Wow.
And it's not toxic.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So I'd like to know what's out there. Can someone maybe contact some of them?
It's a type of clay that they use.
Yeah.
And
it's a lot of
yeah, I think it'd be helpful to give people alternatives, right? From an expert.
So that's a whole different beast now.
Well, that would be a lot to try to bring together in a month.
Right, that's a whole...
Just
that's
a suggestion.
Right.
I don't know if it's practical or not.
I mean, I would like to keep track of, we want to educate the community of why we're doing this, and that it's really is to educate them about what pesticide, herbicide use is about and why we want to have a reduction. And I think that could lead into something and that's more educational down the line about having other people come in to talk about organic pesticide use and maybe someone from UMass Lowell, but I think that would be a bigger project to take on
mm-hmm.
than what the public hearing is for. I think it's still warranted. I just would like to get this out to the public at least.
Right.
So currently our town doesn't have any kind of regulations on pesticides, or do we have some?
Just the state.
Just the state ones.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, this is like 15 years old, too.
Mm-hmm.
It's from 2002 in a lot of other towns.
And we can be more stringent than the mm-hmm. state regulations. We just cannot conflict with them.
Okay. So our regulations were modeled
sure,
more in Marblehead, which is much more current.
Okay.
And those are already, you know, up and running. And they were much more extensive. We cut ours down a little bit. And some of that is DPW had mm-hmm. said, they don't test the compost. They explained what happens in terms of when you spray your grass or whatever, there's a half-life for some of this material, and by the time it's cut and brought to the compost center, it's actually no longer considered dangerous, which is why they don't do the testing for the pesticides.
Yeah, I think as far as the public health aspect, I think we can be more stringent.
Public
I
health.
Mean, as far
yeah.
as
mm-hmm.
what the town bylaws and the town charter says, possibly not, but as far as the public health aspects of regulations, we can be more stringent, but just not conflict with states.
In fact, I have a little blurb on that, too. It says about municipalities.
When did Marblehead implement this? Do you know the answer?
No.
Yeah, probably 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Oh, they were one of the four.
Wow, that's a long time.
A long time ago.
Yeah.
Yeah. They had
a lot of different chemicals back then.
Mm-hmm.
The only curiosity I have is towns that have implemented it and what has been a result of it or an unintended consequence of it. Again, you know, I think you're going to find a lot of folks have no problem that have sidewalks in front of their homes.
Mm-hmm.
I think a lot of folks are going to have problems that don't have sidewalks in front of their homes. I think that's where you're going to get a little pushback on this. At least that's just, maybe you don't, but that's just my thought process. Where the town lawn and their lawn are one.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So it's okay, I can
mm-hmm.
I can go up to here,
mm-hmm.
but I can't go up to there.
Mm-hmm.
So this looks really nice, that doesn't. And there's, I think, where the education part comes in, where it'd be nice to say to that person, well, you could do the whole thing with X application. You know, because this will, you know, this is more approved, this is organic, this will help you out. So that's where I was kind of going with that, with the organic part of it.
I don't think people realize that they are often assuming that the town property is their property.
No, they're not.
That's my point. They don't know that.
No, they don't, but that's part of the problem too, right?
Yes.
So now you're gonna drop the hammer down that it is. So, you know, that's maybe a harsh term, but you know, you're really gonna be informing people, no, that 8 foot from that curb actually is not yours, even though thank you very much for maintaining it all these years.
But if there's a dead tree on it, now you can actually call the cops.
Absolutely. First person to call.
Well,
that was
a little bit about my concern about the town manager and the selectman actually doing the regulations, because do you want to hear, Dan, from the people in town on that regulation? I mean, the Board of Health, I'd be happy to listen to them.
Yeah.
But is the selectman willing to take those calls?
Yeah, I think, though, your discussion should be about a specific set of guidelines you're proposing and have them comment on those guidelines. That would be the most use to us, I think.
Yeah, okay.
Not just an open-ended, gee, we'd like to see this and that.
Yep.
What are you proposing as the Board of Health that we adopt?
Yep.
Okay.
It's consistent with, you know.
Yep, well, that's what the regulations do, so yes, absolutely. Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
Also, how would you publicize this? I mean, typically all that's done for public hearing is to just have a paid ad in the Chronicle. I don't think we're going to get huge amounts of people out for this. So how, I mean, is there any other small steps that might be done manageable to let people know?
If you can figure that out, you let me know. That would be useful information if you can
get
out
of Reading Ranch. It'll get out.
Reading Ranch.
I think we hope to try to do that every time we have an election, is get it out to everybody.
No, yeah, not to everybody, but I mean, I don't know. I mean, there could be like a small article in the Chronicle. I mean, maybe there might be a post on that Reading Parents Network.
What's the
Reading Parents community? They've got about 4,000 members. Are you on that one?
There's about four or five of them. Parents Network's a good one, and I think most schools have their own. I know I'm a Wood End parent. Wood End has the Wood End Parents one. I'm assuming there's Birch Meadow parents and what have you as well. But
just a small little thing, you know. I don't know. Just an effort to reach other people. Honestly, I don't think many people are going to come, but it's still, you know, important to have it.
Come out of
I'm
woodwork.
So sorry.
They're coming out of woodwork.
Well, there's so much October and November, so busy. Yeah.
The town management can assist if you'd like. We have the Administrative Services Department, and they have a whole network of websites and postings that they can
which would be probably
to.
The best avenue for it to come from.
Yeah.
Information-wise.
That's if you're interested.
Yeah, I think that'd be a good idea.
Yeah.
And then we also have, obviously, the how many emails do we have on that on public hearings that you got that sent out from town?
The biweekly notes comes from my office, and that's about 4,000 emails.
4,000 emails that get to public hearing. Like, I just got one today, I think.
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
So would that be possible, Gene, to do like a little blurb that says the Board of Health is considering this, a little summary,
yeah,
and you can see the draft regs? And
a link, yeah, a link right to the date with the reg, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be the best.
Get the law.
They'll defer to the board on what their wishes are.
Yeah, I'd be fine with that. That sounds like a great idea.
That would be great. Is that something we should talk with Laura or you directly with that?
Well, Darlene's going to book the room, so she'll... Did you have a flyer worked up already, or
this is
not yet?
Not yet.
Okay, so we can help with that, and then I can work with Darlene, getting it to Administrative Services, getting it to the Ombudsman, Matt Cornelis, and then he can take it from there and post it where it needs to be posted.
Okay. And what would we like that to say?
Our
little blurb that we're going to have.
Well, why don't we write it now?
Because we would we'd need it fairly soon.
So we want to say Board of Health invites the public.
Okay.
Here's some from different towns, Needham, and Lexington. I guess we could just cut and paste.
There you go.
Makes it easier.
Why reinvent the wheel, right?
Yeah.
And they have some sample flyers and designs too. I don't know. There's.
Oh, that's right.
There's like, I didn't really print those, but.
Is at the bottom right?
This is 15 years old. Yeah. So.
Yeah, but a lot of stuff. Information is the same in terms of what we're trying to do.
Well, this is, you know, you want to keep it simple.
Yeah.
More than anything.
So this is though, this is actually a good educational one, the Lexington, but we have to describe why we're having the hearing. The hearing is the preamble to the Board of Selectmen.
There's a couple more.
Adopting this, correct? So we want to basically say the Board of Health is introducing guidelines for.
Is proposing.
Proposing whatever the, to the selectmen, and we'd like a public, you know, hearing on regulations because, and then we can use maybe one of these.
And I mean, there's some more in the town of Marblehead, there's one, but that's more too.
Well, yeah, these are more proclamations though.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, this is just, we're looking for just a simple couple lines.
Oh, okay.
To get sent out to everybody, so people can say, okay, this is what the hearing is about.
But these are the good ones to basically put in, you know, the newsletter that's coming, these types of information.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. So how did this one, I didn't see the new one. Okay, so yeah, we recommend learn the facts about pesticides, seek or reduce, eliminate pesticide use in the yards at home. So the Board of Health has proposed pesticide guidelines, and we're having a hearing on their use on the tree lawn or something.
Informational hearing with public feedback.
Informational hearing.
With public feedback request.
Hearing with what did you say?
With public feedback request.
Public.
Or requested.
On proposed regulations impacting or involving.
Well, by the Board of Health.
On proposed pesticide regulations by, recommended by the Board of Health. To the Board of Selectmen. These regulations involve, what do you want to say? Because they're not, you know, they're not private property, we're not talking about private property, we're talking about.
Pesticide applications.
Well, that's very good, pesticide applications.
On public, public owned lands, or.
As it.
On public land as defined as, or public land.
Should we town manage or town own as opposed to school?
Okay, town, okay.
We wouldn't have jurisdiction over.
Right, on town managed, is that what you said, town?
Town managed, I guess.
Town managed,
Well, do you want to put town owned? I think town owned rather than town managed.
Yeah.
I wouldn't use the word town managed.
Control owned.
Yeah, town owned.
Town owned tree lawns.
Technically, it's land under the care, custody, and control of selectmen.
That's correct.
And that would take up a little bit more of our.
Yes, it would.
So.
It sounds official.
It does sound official, but then people have no idea what they're talking about.
So the Board of Health, is this real? Okay, Board of Health invites the public to an informational hearing for public feedback, or and public feedback is requested of proposed pesticide regulations recommended by the Board of Health to Board of Selectmen. Concerning pesticide applications on town-owned tree lawns.
Well,
probably a way to make
that
two sentences.
And sidewalks also, so it's.
Tree lawns and sidewalks.
Yeah.
What do you, think when you wrote that up? What do you think? What can we do to trim it up a little bit?
When you say sidewalks, John, obviously sidewalks come to mind when you say that, but. I have this vision of why are we treating sidewalks in the first place? Are you referring to more than just where a sidewalk could be? Is that?
I think sidewalks sometimes is collateral damage to.
Okay, right.
But then there's like the little strip of grass.
Right. No, I know that. I just want to make sure that I'm understanding we're not using sidewalks for a metaphor.
Right.
No, I'm sure you've seen the little sprinkles all along the sidewalk where you may, may walk.
Yeah.
And how is it going to impact like landscaping? Companies
it shouldn't actually impact them at all because all the landscaping companies have told us that they know they're not supposed to treat town-owned land. So it should not impact any.
And so they know that.
They're not supposed to treat town because it's not private property. They can't treat public lands unless they have permission from the town.
Okay.
should have no impact on them at all. So, we'll probably write this out neater for you. And Mary Ellen, I know, is working on it behind me.
I can work with it for you later if you want.
Pardon?
I'm just doodling, but I have to work with it for you later. How's your concept?
All right, so this will be the formal notice that sends out and emails, right?
We can do that by weekly, you know, sure.
Okay, and that'll have a link to the actual time, location, and proposed policy.
Yeah, we could put our proposal up on our website, right, Darlene? Our proposed regulations.
So that's something Darlene will do?
Yes. Darlene, you can get those up on our site, right?
Yeah.
And we can put, just like draft, we can put a big proposed in the background on each page?
Yep.
Okay. Just so people are...
You'll forward those to me, because I...
100% understanding.
Yes. Yep.
Can you copy me on that as well, just in case?
Or Laura could do it. She's got them, but I'll do it.
And obviously we'll have a date, time, location in this as well.
I left these blanks, yeah.
It'd be good to have a hyperlink on, did you write pesticide regulations then?
Invites the Reading public to an informational hearing on October 18th. What day of the week is it?
Wednesday.
Wednesday, October 18th.
At time, at place.
At place, time.
Right.
The hearing is to get public feedback on proposed Board of Health pesticide regulations.
Recommendations for the Board of Selectmen to act on, something like that.
Yeah, what happened to the Board of we get the Board of Selectmen in here.
Right, I'll put that in there.
All right.
It's kind of almost, it's hard to, it gets to be a real long sentence, so I don't know.
On pesticide application.
Or, you know what, leave out Board of Health in the second sentence, because they're saying Board of Health at the top. The Board of Health is sponsoring it. So we don't need to say Board of Health down there. We're saying that these are pesticide application on town-owned tree lawns and sidewalks being recommended. What was the word you said?
How about potential restrictions that the selectmen may impose?
Selective?
How does that sound? Selective? Potential restrictions.
Potential selective restrictions.
Okay.
Potential selective restrictions on pesticide applications on town-owned tree lawns and sidewalks.
You want to have this a restriction?
And I don't want to say selective either. That's kind of...
I think you got selectmen and selective mixed in there. You don't need selective.
Yeah, I gotta say, because that's, potential selectmen, so
no.
Board of Selectmen.
Well,
yeah.
Potential regulations of the Selectmen may enact.
Or how about the recommendations we're proposing to the Board of Selectmen?
Okay,
Done.
Proposed recommendations.
Yeah, I don't know, you want to have a restrictive tenor to what we're doing.
Proposed either regulations or
recommendations to the Board of Selectmen. Okay. you have to write. So now we have, so the Board of Health invites the ready public to an informational hearing on Wednesday, October 18th at place and time. The hearing is... the purpose of the hearing, or do we have to write purpose? The hearing is on...
They can say the purpose of the hearing.
Purpose is... the hearing is on proposed pesticide application. How did you say that, Heidi, originally?
Proposed recommendations.
Proposed recommendations to the Board of Selectmen on pesticide applications.
Yeah, and you
on
might,
town-owned.
Yeah, and you might want to say many other towns or cities like are doing the, you know, like we're following other towns and cities.
No, we don't want to do that. You know, we can inform them that, right? Yeah, we don't want to do that on this.
So, okay, the Board of Health invites the Reading public to an informational hearing on blah, blah, blah. The purpose of the hearing is to recommend to the Board of Selectmen
guidelines.
Thank you, Jenny.
Guidelines on pesticide application on town-owned
tree
lawns
and
sidewalks.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Excuse me, is actually things? I would say either informational meeting or public hearing. I wouldn't use informational hearing together. That doesn't really, you know,
okay.
It's either a public hearing or it's an informational meeting. But I would put it as a public hearing.
Public hearing.
And then invite Reading residents. And it's really to collect their thoughts on it, or their ideas, or
their feedback,
their questions, right?
Right.
So
that's
where
you want to put that in.
So that's our last sentence. We appreciate all feedback and input, or?
Well, I think it's a little awkward wording after place and time, but the purpose of the hearing is to.
Because we really want to get information to give to the Board of Selectmen.
Well, it's to gather, you know, comments. And
comments.
Your feedback, questions from
okay.
citizens about these.
Yeah, I mean, that's what we had originally, to get public feedback, too. That's what
right.
our hearing's for,
yes.
to get information to submit to our select.
So we can just put that little sentence back in, right?
Yeah,
right
yeah.
in.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Good. Yeah, that would be fine. Good.
So will you forward that to?
I can forward it to you, sure. Yeah.
That'd probably be the best. And then I'll figure out with Darlene where we're going to post it. Now, what about the legal ad? Who does that?
For the public.
For the prom.
Darlene, did you. For
I think
the,
you did that last time, Darlene.
Did you do that for
yeah.
the,
yeah.
For the tobacco?
I can do that.
Thank you, Darlene.
Once we get a time and place squared away. Oops. Oh, we got it. Good, I will get that off to you, Jean. And anything else regarding the pesticide regulations at all?
So we're just going to have flyers for people to...
For the meeting, yes. Nancy and I are going to sort of brainstorm for what we're going to do with an informational sheet.
Because that eventually is something that, you know, the hand-ups you brought, Heidi, that we could get into the Public Works newsletter on a regular basis, so particularly in the fall and the spring when people are actually using pesticides, and that would be, I think it's something that would be ongoing. Get a little blurb.
And do you want me to do like a poster?
If you want to work on one, maybe send that to Laura so she can forward it to us. Maybe that would be great.
That would be wonderful. Yeah.
Yeah, that would be
just
fantastic.
So when people kind of come in, they have something right there. Yeah. Okay.
I can just use that report, like some of the
things.
Well, some of the statistics or some of the, little blurbs. Good.
Very good, thank you. Let's see. I guess the last issue I have on the agenda would be the health agent.
I had that, but before we get to that.
Oh, I'm sorry, there's the DPH, yes.
The DPH, and then I had another question about what we had talked about for Narcan.
Okay, yeah, that was the last one, Narcan, yes. Yes, now the DPH follow-up, was there an email?
I sent you his phone number, because I didn't have an email. It was a phone number I put in my emails in the past with his recommendations.
Okay.
Town council had to do.
Okay, because I haven't notified, I haven't been in touch with him yet.
Okay.
The DPH follow-up is regarding?
The camp inspections that were inside.
So Bob Bracy and I are following up on that.
With town council.
Bob Bracy is doing the necessary follow-up, so.
Well, what DPH told us is that we have to have town council actually write up an affidavit.
Yeah, that I think there's maybe more than one way to deal with that, and that's what Bob Bracy's working on.
So could he come back and then inform us, only because this is what DPH is telling us that we have to do to comply for their regulations?
Town council has been looking at this, and I think between town council and Bob Bracy, we have a solution.
So you guys will, I guess, you'll hear what the solution is?
Well, that's why I brought it up on the agenda, just to see if that was what was going on, if that was happening.
Do you know what the solution, you don't know what the solution is yet?
I don't have the information in front of me, I don't.
Okay.
There was also, I did get in touch with, as far as your Narcan issue.
Because this is something I had, you may have seen it in the Globe, it was a really interesting article. Bridgewater State actually did a whole public access Narcan, and I thought it was actually an interesting idea that it might be something that John had talked about joining with
Erica
to perhaps sponsor a community-wide Narcan training. Mm-hmm. And I gave him the name of a pharmacist who actually does this for free, who goes to different clinics, communities, and does Narcan training.
Mm-hmm. So, and you
say Narcan training,
Narcan,
you're not talking about implementing it.
Well, administration of Narcan.
Mm-hmm. For town employees, for town employees, who's
this
training
for? This
is
open to the public, anyone who wanted to come to receive the training.
Public's allowed to get Narcan?
Yeah, you can get it.
Yeah.
Oh, I had no idea about that.
No, this was actually done on a university level to college kids. So it's been really well received in universities. So I know that there are some communities who have done it on a small scale. But
mm-hmm. Well, that's what I had spoken to Erica about with our CASA. Actually, she is going, I think it's tomorrow evening. This is recovery month for our CASA.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe it's tomorrow she's going to a Chamber of Commerce meeting with a lot of the business people in the area. And that's what one of my thoughts were, could she, which I haven't had a chance to do in the last couple of weeks, but maybe speak with some business people about possibly having people trained in the use of Narcan, especially maybe people. There's a lot of towns that have got the flyers up. That last year Steve presented us with a flyer that they were putting up. Well, I guess with our transition, a lot of them either didn't get put up, or she was saying that most towns around Reading have got a lot of flyers up in restrooms around establishments that are open in
restaurants,
the evenings. Restaurants, maybe bars around the surrounding areas, which I guess we may be the only ones that don't have them up now. That's what she had mentioned to me. Mm-hmm. She is going to be seeing these business people I think it's tomorrow night, she's going to bounce off them what they may think of the possibility of having an employee or one or more employees that would be trained in the use of Narcan if needed. Obviously, first responders are the first ones there, and they get there as soon as they can, but unfortunately, that's, that sometimes is not fast enough. I've asked her if she may be willing to come in and give us a little presentation to the board about what she's doing and what she feels about it. That I'd like to get her in here at some point to have a talk about it. Did you have any questions at all about that, about the use of Narcan or?
I went to try to get it at a pharmacy and they don't have the nasal spray anymore. At least that's what the pharmacist told me, that now it's recommended injecting. That's the Rite Aid and Rite Aid. So
really?
I had to think about it.
Gee, that's not what I had.
So I don't know, like it would be, you know, someone who trains. I was looking for the nasal one, but
yeah. He
said it's recommended now for an injection, so.
Really, I'm not sure, yeah.
Not that I'm aware of. I mean, there is an auto injector now, sort of like an EpiPen type thing, but there's still, I think the nasal spray is the most common thing available.
I think that's what a lot of families actually end up getting is the nasal. And that, you know, and again, I know that the pharmacist that came to Jack's place, you know, was informative, and they basically gave the training, a lunchtime training.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I spoke with, actually, I left a message. We've been back and forth with messages. I haven't spoken to him.
Okay.
Was he up in Gloucester? Is that his?
He's
home?
Up in Gloucester.
Okay.
Yeah, he goes around and does these trainings for free.
Now, is that something the board would be comfortable looking into? Is potential, maybe business people in town being able to administer or us sponsoring that type of thing?
Yeah, I think like what Nancy said, you know, anybody who's interested in town, you know, to learn, because like you said,
families
people keep it.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure, it might be tricky trying to get train different people, I don't know, in the town.
Well, and Erica seems to be pretty good with that too. We'll get her ideas on that also to see just what she thinks.
Yeah,
you envision doing this with our CASA?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
I think I would plan on talking to the fire chief too.
Fire and police.
Mm-hmm.
They've had direct experience. They know the do's and don'ts.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And any information we give the public, I think, is just it's all extra help.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No. As far as the public health aspect of it, that's a big thing.
Mm-hmm.
That's public safety.
Yeah. And I don't know. Bridgewater State, that's a whole different issue because that's on the university level and,
mm-hmm.
and all this, but I'm sure we don't have to recreate the wheel from communities,
mm-hmm.
particularly from Gloucester, right?
Yep, yeah.
So.
Okay, and we'll have to do some more research on that
too,
but I just wanted to get the board's idea if
mm-hmm.
they thought that might be going in the right direction.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so. Certainly a public health crisis, the opioid addiction.
Any other issues as far as the board to address at all, or?
Did you have anything else before we close?
Well, just as far as like a long-term thing, just as far as public health aspect is, just immunizations. I'd have to maybe speak with Jane. Jane Burns is that contact in town. But as far as making immunizations, maybe whether it be flu shots, pneumonia immunizations, that's a pretty big thing as far as the public health of, especially people over 65 with the pneumonia.
Really, people think of immunizations for their children, so
mm-hmm.
we're really
yeah.
talking about this adult population.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep. Is Walmart showing any interest in the pneumonia shot for over 65?
I would imagine they do. I know where I work, that is becoming a very big issue. With the two pneumonia shots, they're out.
Right.
I think the estimates are probably 60% of people over 65 have had a pneumonia shot,
mm-hmm.
wow.
but there are now two different strains that over 65 you should get, and I think a lot of people are just not aware of that.
There's two different strains, and how then do they determine which, that's based on the primary care's assessment of their physical health?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, basically, they're saying just about everyone should be immunized with both.
With both.
If you're over 65.
Oh, with both. Okay.
Yeah.
The, one of them is quite a bit newer than the other one that's been around for a while. So a lot of people have had the one that's been around for a while. But it would be important to get both.
Okay.
And then
if you get it at your annual checkup, which is no cost under current health care plan, you might get the immunization thrown in.
Yeah, well, Medicare will cover a year apart. They'll cover both pneumonia vaccines over 65.
What about the shingles vaccine?
Well, that's
over
another
60.
One.
I think you
that's
picked.
Another one.
Yeah.
That's for over 60, but it's only like 65% effective or 60%
effective. Well, it's very effective. It's not a total. If you get the vaccine, it doesn't mean that you won't get it.
It lessens the severity,
yeah.
But if it doesn't,
right.
Prevent it.
Right.
Yeah.
But it is beneficial to get it when you're over 60. But that's
so, but
just
that actually would be a nice thing going into the fall season,
mm-hmm.
to get an article and then to do a little bit more follow up on that.
Yes, yes. I mean, I could even write an article on it if you'd like.
Okay. Yeah, and then even to get a sense, is it Jane Burns at the Senior Center?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If we want to target that population,
mm-hmm.
in a different way with this information, or
mm-hmm.
we get it out in the paper, though.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds like actually a really good article for the fall.
Yep, yep.
Okay. The other article I would like to think about us doing, as kind of an outgrow of the Board of Selectmen with Keno, is to write something on gambling.
Ooh.
In terms of, because we're going to have an increase in Keno, I believe, in town.
Is Keno going to come to Reading? Yes.
Yeah.
It's here.
It's
here.
Increased. So it would be nice if we could also just keep abreast with that.
Okay.
And I will put that down as
okay.
a possibility,
yeah,
just to be mindful of talking about addictions. Because it's something that's often overlooked, but for every dollar the state brings in for gambling, they lose two in social services.
I don't know if we have had a history of writing articles over the, and that's, they're posted, if you look at the website, our website, you'll notice on the left there are some of the articles we've had over the past, what, couple of years now, I guess,
mm-hmm.
right? Mm-hmm.
It's kind of,
on the articles, if I'm remembering correctly, those got sent again to the ombudsman, to
mm-hmm.
Matt Cornelis?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
that's important.
I don't think we've had one in several months, but yes, that's SOP, yes.
Yeah, but I think the immunizations with flu season, that would be more timely, I think,
mm-hmm.
for us to focus on.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'll see if I can get that out fairly soon. That would be, that's important. You're right.
And like for elderly people, they recommend the high potency flu vaccine. So I guess I'm assuming Walmart, they must do that.
Over 65, I would
you're
assume
supposed to get
that
a different one.
I would assume so, yes. Mm-hmm. And anything else? We're getting out just in time. What is it, 7 o'clock? We have a room switch.
The only thing I'm going to hand out before you call the meeting, because I don't need to discuss this actually at all, but I'm going to give everybody the package that I sent to the selectmen. Just so you're aware of what I sent to the selectmen.
Good idea.
And that's yours. We don't need to discuss this.
All right.
They've
mm-hmm.
been sent it in the mail. Okay.
I think that was apropos to copy to the quorum, because that was just information. It wasn't anybody's opinion about something. So that's a good example where you can copy everybody.
This is what I sent to the Board of Selectmen.
Right. And you copied
and
the board.
I'm yeah. giving it to the board right now. What I sent to.
Well, they're on your copy already. Did you know that? The thing you sent to me was copied to your fellow.
No, you're getting this in the mail.
I'm missing my point.
Okay.
I think you did an okay thing by just disseminating information. What John had done before was to send his opinion through staff. That's what you have to avoid. That's what Ray was worried about. I think sending information, pure information out is fine.
Right.
Yes.
It's pure information.
And that's all right, yeah.
Okay.
All right, anything else for the board? Meeting is adjourned at 6:56. Thank you very much.